Today we are going to talk about communication stack, shortly called as comstack. So in this video we are going to explore, begin with AutoSAR architecture overview, then what is comstack, and inside comstack we will go one by one, AutoSAR com and PDUR, then CAN TP, CAN interface and CAN state manager and CAN network management and CAN transceiver and CAN driver. Let's start with AutoSAR architecture. As we know, the AutoSAR layer is split into three parts. One is ASW and below layer is BSW and in between RTE, that is called runtime environment. BSW, we have three layers. One is for MCAL, that is microcontroller abstraction layer, and middle layer is ECU abstraction layer, and upper layer is service layer. And above that we have a runtime environment, then above RTE we have application layer. So RTE will connect BSW to ASW. Here you can see a lot of stacks are there. So this is called comstack, and this memory board is called memstack, and DAC stack, likewise mode management and OS. And in this video we are only concentrated about comstack. Here you can see AutoSAR comstack alone segregated from BSW layer. So here we have AutoSAR com, PDE router and bus TP and bus IF. Likewise we have MCAL layer, CAN drivers and IO drivers are there. So in this video we are going to talk about CAN IF and CAN TP, so related to CAN protocol. So here you can see AutoSAR com and PDR router and bus TP, which means CAN TP and CAN IF. These are for data transmission and reception, and this section is for state management, and bus NM is nothing but CAN or flex ray. This is for network management. AutoSAR com module. AutoSAR com module, which is located in between RTE and PDA router. So basically it is a OSACOM specification and provide uniform specification to the CAN network. AutoSAR COM is responsible for providing signal level access to the application layer, likewise PDU level access to the lower level layer. So PDU is nothing but a protocol data unit, which is consist of protocol control information PCI plus STU, service data unit. So here application layer send the signals to the AutoSAR COM. It will pack to the PDU. So as I said, PDU, which is consist of PCI and STU, and it will send to the PDU router. So likewise in the receiver side, it will receive the PDU data from PDU router, and it will unpack and send the signal to the application layer. Here you can see it pack the signal to a PDU at the transmitter, which means COM module get the signals from the application layer and pack it as a PDU at the transmitter section. Likewise, unpack the received PDU and it will send to the application layer as a signal. And at the PDU level, COM is responsible for grouping of PDU, like it will do starting and stopping of the PDU group. And PDR router. So here you can see the PDR, which is get the input from bus IF, which means here we are talking about CAN, so CAN IF, and get the input from CAN IF and send the data to the AutoSAR COM modules. Sometimes if CAN data is more than 8 bit of data, so it will get the input from bus TP, which means CAN TP, and send data to the AutoSAR COM. So likewise application layer is, if it send 8 bit of data, then it will directly transmit to CAN IF. Suppose if it is more than 8 bit of data, it will send PDR route to the CAN TP and it will send to the CAN IF. PDR is also responsible for gatewaying. So here you can see normally PDR router get the data from bus IF, which means CAN IF. So when it is 8 bit of data, so PDR directly get the data from CAN IF. Suppose if CAN is more than 8 bit of data, then it will PDR get the data from CAN TP and it will receive the PDU and send the received PDU to the another bus specific, I mean CAN interface or CAN TP. So here I have mentioned The PDU router also accomplishes the gateway functionalities when the PDU is routed from one controller to another over the same protocol. And CAN-TP, I have created one video about CAN-TP, so click on the above link, then you'll get more details on CAN-TP. So I give you basics example here. So normally CAN-TP, so CAN-TP, here the bus interface, here we are talking about CAN, so CAN interface. So normally CAN-TP get the input from CAN-IF. So if CAN-IF data is 8-bit of data, so PDR router is directly get the input from CAN-IF. If it is more than 8-bit of data, so we need a CAN-TP. So it has a mechanism, it will send more than 8-bit of data to the PDR router. So simply I would say it's a segmentation and unsegmentation. And next one is CAN-IF, which means CAN interface. So CAN interface, which is part of ECU abstraction layer, so which is responsible for transmit request, transmit confirmation, and reception indication, control mode control, and PDU mode control. Here you can see the basic terms used in CAN-IF. The one is HOH, that is called hardware object handle, which is nothing but a buffer. And second one is basic CAN and full CAN. Hardware object handle, HOH. Normally CAN-IF, it will call CAN driver, it will get the some CAN related parameters like CAN ID and DLC and data. So while transmitting, hardware transmit handle, and while reception, hardware receive handle will handle this data like CAN ID and DLC and data. Basic CAN and full CAN. The CAN-IF can distinguish between basic CAN and full CAN. So full CAN is, it can accept only single CAN ID. Basic CAN means it will accept range of CAN ID. So here I have mentioned a CAN hardware object for full CAN operation only enable transmission reception for single CAN ID, which means 0x700 or 0x78F like that. But when you come back to the basic CAN, it will allow the range of CAN ID. It will enable the transmit and receive for range of CAN ID in between 700 to 7FF like that. So basic CAN and full CAN object can coexist in single CAN and variation setup. And CAN-IF abstract the CAN hardware object, which means nothing but it's a buffer. The CAN-IF call the data from MCAL layer, which means CAN drivers, and it abstract the inputs CAN ID and DLC and data by the handle called hardware object handles. And it told the PDU to different CAN controls and CAN transceivers, and it control the CAN controller state transfer of the CAN SF, and it communicate the state changes to the upper layer. Then transmission PDU and reception PDU. In case of transmission PDU, the CAN-IF is responsible for mapping HRS to the CAN hardware object, which means it will determine the hand driver and it will write the data into CAN write API. Once the CAN write API is completed, it will notify the upper layer about the transmission is successful. Likewise, if it is a in case of reception PDU, the CAN-IF is responsible for filtering of the received PDU and DLC checks and buffering of the received PDU and indicating the upper layer about the PDU receptions. Most of these features are provided by CAN-IFs are configurable only. CAN transceiver driver, which is submodule of the CAN-IF. The primary functionality of the CAN transceiver driver, which is used to control the external CAN transceiver hardware, which means it will monitor and control the wake up and sleeping process of the CAN bus and regulate the CAN bus. This driver also observes the bus line and transmit physical network layer diagnostic information to the appliance layer. CAN driver. CAN driver module is a part of MCAL layer, which is nothing but microcontroller abstraction layer. It will provide the hardware access to the upper layer service and the hardware independent interface to the upper layers. CAN-IF is the only module that can access the CAN drivers. So what's the purpose? So CAN driver is responsible for controlling the transmission of CAN frames on the hardware. It will notify the reception by calling the callback function. The second one is CAN state manager. So this module is implement the control flow for the respective bus. So the main purpose of the candidate manager is it will handle the startup and shutdown feature that depend on the communication type. So when application layer send the data, so it will call the scan state manager. It will verify the CAN controller status, whether it is a backup or whether it is ID, like that. Once it is give the confirmation, then only application layer allowed to send data to the layer. So application layer directly not allowed to send data unless and until the CAN state manager verify the CAN transceiver and CAN controller state. Once it's confirmed, then only the application layer allowed to send data to the layer. And next one is CAN network management. The AUTOSAR CAN network management is a hardware independent protocol tool that can only used for CAN network. So the main purpose of the CAN network management, it coordinate the transition between normal operation and bus leaf mode of the network. So it will manage the normal operation, bus leaf operation. The CAN network management, the function provide the adoption, which means adoption between CAN network management, which means NMIF and CAN-IF module. So next we will see the communication flow of COMSTACK. Like I said before, so the COMSTACK is split into three sections. One is for section A and section B and section C. Like I said, the section is called for data transmission and reception management. So here you can see the lower level layer is physical layer, and above that, top of that, bus layer and bus interface, and bus interface which is communicated to section B and also section C, which means state management and network management, and bus interface which is directly connected to the PDR. Suppose if a data is more than 8 bit of data, then the TP will handle and it will send data to the PDR. On top of PDR, it will send the signal to the it will send the data to the PD to the COM, and COM will extract the signal to the application layer. So here you can see the second one is for section B, the state management. Like I said before, the application layer is not allowed to send data directly, so it need to be get touch with bus state management. So it will monitor the CAN transmitter and CAN controller. Once it will give the confirmation, then only the application layer allowed to send data to the layer. The same thing for network management. So the application layer get the EOK, means a confirmation from this thing, section B and section C, then only it allowed to send data to the layer. So this is what I have mentioned here, and here you can see the section A. Section A is segregated, I mentioned here. So when the data is received, then it will inform to the bus interface layer. Then bus IF, it will communicate it with the bus TP, which means here we're talking about CAN. So it will communicate with PDR and COM and RT and application layer and vice versa. And next one is for section B. And so here application layer, it will communicate it to the COM by the help of RTE, and it will get the input from state manager, and bus IF, it will interact with the state manager and bus driver and the vice versa. The same thing for network management, bus driver, IF and NNM and NM and RTE and application and vice versa. Thanks for watching.